I, Carlo Séquin, will prove to you that any triangle that you draw is equilateral. That means it has the same length of the sides all around. So I'm starting with three intersecting lines, and a second one here, and a third one here. And I mark the intersection vertices as the vertices of a triangle, A, B, and C. That does not look, you know, equilateral, not too far off, but it's certainly arbitrarily drawn. Now I'm taking the middle point of the side BC, I call this M, and I draw the perpendicular bisector. So I'm drawing a line that's perpendicular coming out of M, going off in that particular direction. And of course, we have a right angle here. Now you know that this line is the locus of all the points that are equidistant from point B and from point C. I'm going to draw another extra line, and that is the angle bisector coming out of A here. So that should look something like that, I guess. And this line, of course, let's call it angle divider D, is the locus of all the points that are equidistant from lines AB and from line AC. So if I'm going to the intersection point between those two lines, which is about here, which I'm calling X, then I know that this point is equidistant from B and from C because it lies on the perpendicular bisector. So let's draw these two lines, and we know that these are equal because we're on the perpendicular bisector. Okay, but also if I draw the shortest distance from X to line AB, which might look something like that, and comes in, of course, at the right angle here, and I draw the shortest distance from X onto line AC and at the right angle here, let's call this point B star, and let's call this point C star, then I know that X B star is equal to X C star because we're on the angle bisector and these are all the points that are equidistant from those two lines. Okay, now we focus on these two small triangles. And here we have a triangle with a right angle. Adjacent to the right angle, we have this double marked line X B star. And here we have a right angle, and adjacent to the right angle, we have this double marked line X C star, and we know these two lines are the same length. We also have the third side of the triangle, which is opposite of the right angle, marked with this one slash, and it's the same as this slash over here. That's the hypotenuse in this case. And so because two triangles, when they have two equal sides, and they have the longer side being opposite to an angle that also happens to be equal, then these two triangles are congruent. As a matter of fact, in this case, you can see they're basically mirror images of one another. Now, this of course tells us that we also now know that B, B star, then must be equal to C, C star. B, B star, mark it with three slashes, equal to C, C star. Now, we have more congruent triangles. We also have the triangle A, X, B star, being a mirror image of A, X, C star. Yeah. And so those two triangles are congruent. And this, of course, tells us that A, B star equals to A, C star. Okay, now, what can we conclude from all that? Well, we can say that A, B star minus B, B star is really just the side AB. And we can say that A C star minus C C star is just the side AC. Now we're almost there. We have proven up here that AB star is equal to AC star. We have proven that BB star is equal to CC star, okay? And so these two sides being equal, it essentially then follows that AB equals AC. So we have done nothing special about the triangle, and we have now proven that these two sides are of equal length.
So we've got an isosceles triangle.
That's right. And now, of course, I can go around and do exactly the same construction on two other sides, making this what was A before and proving that these two sides are the same, with the same construction hanging off to this side. I don't have to do it a third time, because once I've proven that, I can really show that all sides of this triangle are of equal length. I can just start from another vertex, draw my angle bisector, do do my perpendicular bisector over there and do exactly the same construction. So you of course know that this cannot possibly be true. And so I encourage you to go very carefully, step by step, through here and try to find out, you know, where is that one bogus step? So be vigilant. Go for it.